Alright, hello guys and welcome again. I want to do a quick little demonstration today about soldering two wires together. I'm going to do a demonstration with, this is I believe 24 gauge wire, and then I've got some thicker 18, and we're going to solder the 18 to some 14. Do a little quick demonstration. But before we get into the soldering, I want to talk about a little theory first. So the idea is we've got this wire. This is the wire. The insulation has been stripped back. And we're going to add our soldering iron. It's really a lot about heat management. So right now the wire is at room temperature. And so we add this soldering iron. Soldering iron obviously is very hot, and I want to add the soldering, the iron, the tip of the iron, to say maybe the halfway point to this, in this region. I don't want to get too close to the insulation, because wherever you touch this wire, the heat is going to radiate outwards, and we want to keep the heat preferably away from the insulation because it'll melt. Copper is a really good conductor of heat, so as you add the iron, it's going to cause the wire this direction and this direction to get hot. We want to add the soldering iron to the bottom of the wire. So if it's sitting here in my vise, like so, I want to come up from the bottom and add the iron to the bottom. Why? Because heat rises. If you're trying to put the soldering iron on the top, it'll still work, but I want to use the properties of heat to help warm up my material. So I'm going to add the soldering iron to the bottom. As I add the iron, this point right in this area is going to warm up first. My iron is going to have a little bit of solder already on it, and that little bit of liquid solder, as I touch the wire here, is going to help transfer more heat so that the wire heats up quicker. Then I want to take the solder, if this is my little piece of solder here, and I want to add it to this spot right where the iron meets the wire, so that when it melts, it wants to travel up into the wire. As it heats up, I can start moving it along the wire, and I'm going to move the iron and the solder along the edge of the wire to the tip as I keep adding a little bit more solder until the entire surface of the wire has a uniform coating of solder. This is called tinning. We want to tin, I don't know, maybe there's only one end in there, but it's tinning the wire. I want to do this tinning process on each wire, so this side and this side, before I try to mate the wires. Let's see, the solder I'll be using today, this is a 60-40 blend, 60-10, 40 lead. This is a no clean flux, and the size, it's pretty thin. I like to work with some fairly thin stuff. This is 22 gauge or 0.032 inches in diameter. It has flux inside, so we don't need to add any extra flux. I'll just cut off a little piece. I'm gonna strip the edge of the insulation back just a little bit, and then twist these wires, the strands of the wires, together just to make it nice and clean. I'll put that in my little helping hands vise here. Give you a better look at the vise there. Heavy metal plate, some magnetic, these little arm clamps here. Works really well. Okay, strip the other one. I'm Oops, buggled that a little bit. It looks like that one's just a little bit thinner. Okay, so just like we talked about before, I'm gonna take my iron. I'm gonna put just a little bit of solder on it. I'm gonna add the iron to the back portion of the wire. I'm gonna add solder until it starts to melt, and then come along the rest of the length of the wire. Once the wire is warm enough to accept the solder, I work my way out to the edge of the wire. Start back here, add the solder, it heats up, and then work my way out. Oops, got a little extra. So now, if we look at if we look at the wire, it has a nice even coating of solder all the way. There's solder filling up all the strands on the inside. It's a nice even coating. In this demonstration, I'm going to talk about where we're talking about mating two wires. So I'm going to use a little heat shrink here. This is 3M brand 3/32 size heat shrink. I've already have a piece cut. And so it's pretty helpful to put the heat shrink on before you do this, unless you're like me and you want to solder it together and then take it apart and then put it back on with the heat shrink. I'd usually recommend you put the heat shrink on the first time. Oops, whoa, that's not hit the camera. So now that I'm going to take this side out. Now that we've got both sides tinned, I don't really need to add any extra solder. I'm just going to add both of these wires together. I'm going to heat up all of the solder on both of the wires. Get them right next to each other. Let it cool. And we have a nice solder joint. The solder fills up all of the, you don't see a valley between the two wires. It looks fairly shiny. There we go. It's a nice pretty solder joint. I'm gonna add this back in to my helping hands here. I'm gonna bring this piece of heat shrink tubing. The heat shrink tubing. So if you see, there's the solder joint. I'm gonna bring this over right into hopefully the center of the heat shrink. Handy dandy heat gun. And then just heat this evenly on all sides until there's no more shrinking. And now we have soldered our two wires together. Okay. The solder joint here is going to be the strongest part of this. Most likely the weakest part will be at the very edge. If you use a pair of wire cutters or wire strippers like these, and if you damage any of the strands when you strip the wire back, that will most likely be the weakest spot. So if I were to pull on this and break it, it'll probably break right there if I damaged any strands. I try not to do that. But that solder joint in there is going to be the strongest point. Okay. I'm going to try this one more time, but we're going to use some 18 gauge. Oops. Some 18 gauge stranded. And some 14 gauge, also stranded. Use a different type of wire stripper here. like to twist the strands. And we'll do that with this one as well. Oops, let's go a little tiny bit more. I like to use, you want to make sure that the amount that you stripped off is pretty even so that you don't have, you know, a big overlap here, a big overlap there, or one's longer than the other. Try to make them about as even as possible. All right. I'm going to take our heat shrink. If you want to tin the wires first, sometimes I like to tin the wires before I get started, or before I put the heat shrink on, just so I don't damage any strands. And to tin the wires, add a little solder to the iron, bring the soldering up underneath, add the solder right where the two meet, and work my way to the end. And you'll see, you can kind of see and feel as you're adding the solder, once the wire is hot enough, it just allows you to put almost as much solder on at a time as you want. You don't want to get too much because then you'll end up with a big ball. If you don't do enough, you'll end up with bare spots. I'm going to add the soldering iron to the bottom. Add the solder right where the iron meets. Try to get some of that solder to flow. This is much thicker wire. It's going to take a little bit more time to heat up. Once it starts to take the solder, work my way towards the outside. I missed. There's a bare spot right there. So if we look at this up close, you can see that it looks really smooth. You can hardly see the strands in most cases. You can kind of see some strands here, but it's the whole wire is covered. The outside, the inside, the solder has gotten inside of all of the, where all of those strands are. Now we can take our little piece of heat shrink. This heat shrink is slightly larger. This is this heat shrink is 3:1, whereas the last one I showed you is 2:1. This is a little thinner. It's a little bit larger. And I'm going to put the heat shrink on over the wire before I solder these together. I'm going to put the two wires together. Remember that the bigger, thicker wire is going to take more heat and more time to warm up, melt all the solder. Once you see that all that solder is starting to melt, the two wires, you want to get both wires fused together. You want enough solder on there to make sure that there's no valley in between. You can see, especially on this side, the lower side where the gravity wants to pull the solder, there's no valley here. Oh, come on, focus. There's no valley between the two wires. This side almost can kind of see a little bit of valley. I think it's more of a shadow than anything. You can kind of see maybe there's a little bit of strands on the black wire, but they are pretty well filled in. And then of course we have our heat shrink. I put the heat shrink, here's the center of the wire. Try to get that heat shrink in the center there. Use our heat gun. Try to get a nice even heat on all the sides, trying not to heat up the insulation because we don't want to melt the insulation. And it's done. One of the things I'm looking for is this particular type of heat shrink has a glue type epoxy on the inside, and you can see some of it starts to leak out right here. Same thing with this side. You can see there's a little bit of shiny bubble stuff here. This is the glue from the inside of the heat shrink. It's uniform around the end here of the heat shrink on both sides. It's pretty uniform. And this helps keep moisture and debris and whatnot out of the heat shrink, so you don't get anything in there that might start corroding or making your solder joint go bad. And that's how you solder two wires together. Thanks for watching.